Good afternoon, YouTube. I'm working on my Toyota 4Runner. This is actually the rear axle. I've got a full floater axle in it, so I have the locking hubs and chromoly axle shafts in there. And the reason I'm pulling this apart, if we look through there, see, I've got the rear drive shaft off, and recently I've been getting a lot of just intermittent clunking and noises, and the other day it got really loud. I unlocked the rear hubs, which disconnects the axle shafts from the wheels, but I left the drive shaft was still in place here, and then I put it in four-wheel drive, and without any load on the rear axle I was still getting the noise. So my next step was to remove the rear drive shaft, because the Toyota transfer case doesn't have a front rear wheel drive selector. You get rear wheel drive or four wheel drive. So I pulled the rear drive shaft and left the hubs unlocked, and the noise goes away. So the only two options then were that the locking hub messed up, and they are indeed okay. So that leaves just one thing left here, which is the differential inside. I suspect I have a broken ring or pinion gear, and there's probably a broken off tooth that gets kicked up into the gears every once in a while. So that is what I'm suspecting, so I need to pull that out. Luckily, with the full floater kit, you can just pull the axle shafts out, and you don't need to remove the whole rear axle on your drum brake and semi-floater rear axle. You've got to unbolt this axle flange from the axle itself and pull the whole wheel out. So that is a major undertaking. You've got to disconnect your hydraulic brake lines, disconnect the e-brakes, and then unbolt the whole rear axle, the four bolts that hold it to the axle housing, and then you've got to slide that out. So luckily with the full floater, all you have to do is get in here and pull the hub. So what I'm doing right now, I pulled off the locking assembly to look inside, and now what I have to do is pull off the rest of the hub, because the splines end inside the hub there, so I can't pull this out far enough by itself. So I need to actually disconnect the hub body there, or the locking hub body. And if anybody's ever worked on a Toyota, you've got these cone washers, is what they're called. This is what they look like. That's one that actually the whole stud came out for me. But these cone washers are tapered. They're kind of conical shaped washers, or cone washers, and they fit into a tapered hole. And when you tighten the nut down, they clamp onto the stud very tightly. And one of the problems is when you go to leak them off, they don't want to come off. So there's a really easy way to do that. And what you do is you get yourself a brass drift. So I picked this up a long time ago. One little modification I did was put a little bit of a center hole in there. You put that over the stud and then tap this with a hammer, and that'll usually pop these things loose. So let me give that a try. And because you can see right here, all of these washers are stuck. They're not, oh, that one's loose. So sometimes they come off loose like that. That one's loose. You can sometimes get a screwdriver into the slot. But like this one here, well, that one came off. And let's see if I can find, yeah, that one's loose. So sometimes you can get in there with a screwdriver and work them loose if you can find the slot. Let me get these other two off of here and then we'll take a look. Okay, we got them all loose here. So now all I need to do is get in here and you pull them out like that. You can see how they're cone-shaped. They've got that split in there. So when they are pushed into that tapered hole around the stud, they collapse and just bite down really hard on the stud. So let's see here. There's two. You have to be careful though grabbing, because if you grab across the slot, you'll tighten the washer back down. So you have to grab like I am here with the slot under the pliers, and then it comes off. They work really well. They really grab onto the studs, and they don't loosen up, because you can see here, even without the nut on the stud, it's still stuck in there. That one's got to get lined up a little better. But yeah, there we go. So that's pretty much my task for tonight, is to get these off of here, and then I just want to be able to pull the axle shaft out a little bit so I can remove the third member in the morning and take a look at that, because I think that's my problem, because this is all looking good in here. So I'll show you what it looks like when I get all those washers off of there. Okay, there I got the last one off. You can see this one is kind of deformed a little bit. That was one that was really stuck on there. So what I need to do before I put it back on is tap a flat blade screwdriver into that slot to open it up a little bit, and maybe run a round file through the hole just to get rid of the burrs. Because if you put that back on and it's collapsed like that, it'll be a problem next time you try to get it off. So I always like to fix them up before I put them back on, just so you're not creating a bigger problem later on. But now, look at that, there we go. So there I've got my axle shaft slid out. So I think I will leave this for tonight. It's starting to get dark, and then I'll pull the third member out. I got to drain the gear oil out. Maybe I'll try to do that tonight. Let it drain overnight, and then I can pull it out in the morning. That's how the infamous cone washers can be removed. So like this particular hub, three of them came off with just the screwdriver. So I was able to get a screwdriver in there. Two of them I needed to hit with the brass drift, and that loosened them up. And then one of them, this one, I had to shove the screwdriver in there and get it to open up a little bit. So you kind of use the screwdriver like a little chisel in there, and you're pushing the screwdriver into the slot to spread it open, because this one is kind of deformed. So if we look at another one here, you can see how the slot is wide open on that one. Compared to that one, it's not wide open. So that one I need to clean up a little bit before I put her back on. So yeah, there's the hubs off, and we'll take a look at the third member, which I assume I've got a chewed up ring or pinion gear or both. Usually they both go, so I'll show you what that looks like in the morning here. Catch you later.